I used my camera as a gun. I was prepared to die for my freedom. No one was going to stop me from taking pictures. When I was young, Sofar Town was full of gangsters. I was forced to take up boxing so that I can defend myself. So whenever they want to do something, I just tell them, don't touch me. You touch me, I'll beat the hell out of you. Through photography, we are able to see how the world operates. You tell so many words with one picture. And I said, this is my country, South Africa. My camera will give my country the freedom. I was fighting for my rights and fighting to get the picture for my newspaper.
What's extraordinary about Peter Magubane's career is that his photos went all around the world. They left South Africa and they made an impact on people. They gave an insight into what the people of South Africa were struggling with.
I am there as a photographer. I should capture what I see because I want the world to see what kind of animal is apartheid. I was arrested, detained for 586 days in solitary confinement. I was banned from working as a photographer, but I used to work. I was not going to be made not to do my work. No. You arrest me, you're making me worse. Some women were arrested for not carrying their passes. And I said to myself, the only way I can get the pictures is let me go and buy a half a loaf of bread, put my camera inside the bread and pretend as if I'm eating and take pictures. And I succeeded.
And if we can get you almost crouching and look intensely into that camera, without Peter Magubane, you would not see what was happening in South Africa during the apartheid era. Go back 40, 50 years, there was no internet. At that time, you are relying on brave souls showing injustice in South Africa.
If the system of today does not give me what I want, does not give the people what they want, I will not pack my bags and go. I will document.